Hello? I can't hear you. Who is this?
Don't
How did you get my number? Can you help me? What the fuck is going on in this town? You're... what? You're up on the roof? I can't hear what you're saying. Hello? Hello, are you still there? Ah, shit.
Ah! prior to what he insists on describing as the Black Day. His school and home life were no-go topics when discussing these feelings and anxieties. He told me the other day that he'd been seeing hallucinations, but couldn't give a clear description of what he'd been seeing. Naturally, I didn't take him seriously. I saw no evidence to suggest this was the case, but upped his prescription anyway. He claims the extra medication helps.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're crazy.
Don't go there.
I'm close enough.
Don't go there.
I can't. There's a big fucking gate in the way.
That's why I want you to come closer. How about you?
How?
I need a gun.
You got a gun! The subway. The guy you shot. Remember?
I want a new gun.
Look. Just open the gate, will you? I'm tired of all this.
No. Take me a gun and hide it. Now.
I know. I have it already.
Good. Give it to me right now. It's mine. Then I'll give it to you.
Here. There's no ammo in it, though. There you are. You're dead. You're so fucking dead.
Simon, the pills by itself won't make you feel better. You have to do something more than that. I recommend that you try a new modern treatment called cognitive therapy.
What's that?
It's a set of exercises. Past all the bad memories and anxiety you have. Are you interested in books, Simon?
I don't know. Why?
All right. I just wanted to find out. Because I want you to try out something. I want you to write a book. A book about how you feel. Do you think you can do that?
I guess so. I can try.
Mom's okay. Mom? I stopped myself from doing it, from committing suicide. But it didn't only leave me alive, it also left two police officers dead. I killed them. Shot them both. This was not supposed to happen. Doctors testified that I was having a psychosis, which means that my punishment won't be too hard for me to bear. I have to spend the rest of my life in a mental hospital, where nurses and doctors are taking care of me. They let me finish my book, and it has helped me a lot. I wrote a happy ending, just for myself. I feel better now. I am more at peace with myself, even though I'm still stuck in this wheelchair. But I accept that now. I can never forgive myself for shooting those two officers, though. But I have so many supportive people around me now, so I think I will be okay. Dr. Purnell is mentoring me and is watching my progress. I am lucky to have him. Sophie visits me every once in a while. When the doctors let her, that is. They still think her visits are too destabilizing for me and that it hinders my progress.